Cyberbullies in the house.
Out your face.
For the extreme retro review for ECW, August 8th, 1995. I should note, on the Tape Trader edition of the show, this was the August 13th, 1995 edition of Hardcore TV. Real weird.
It is weird.
46 minutes and 44 seconds for those with the Tape Traders for extreme retro review number 143. H-Dub, your thoughts and views of this show, as well as the time for the WWE Network.
What's up, everybody? The time for Hardcore TV episode number 120, as my compatriot established the August 8th show on the network, was 41 minutes and 11 seconds. Felt like a good... It was interesting that was 46 on your end, so it was, I guess, it was, you know what I'm saying, it's a lot more in line time-wise, which is interesting. So, anyway, my thoughts, it was a good little mini show. It just felt light. I don't know if it's because, you know, it wasn't a whole lot going on too much outside of, I think it was two matches on there, but... You know, it was all right for what was in there. Just, I don't know, felt like a small fries instead of a large fries, I guess.
No cold open as we have Joey at the Nest. He's shilling a card from some fairground in New York. It shows clips of various matches. Sandman versus Cactus Jack, part Infinity. They got Cactus Jack riding bitch on a motorcycle to come down.
Yes. Why was he riding bitch on a motorcycle?
At no point should you ride bitch on any motorcycle. We have said this on occasion before. I know we have. There's no way in any part and piece of the multiverse where a male should be allowed to ride behind. I don't care if they're homosexual. They shouldn't still be riding behind each other on a goddamn motorcycle.
Yeah, that is awful. Awful. Awful.
It is just the complete definition of emasculation. Emasculation.
And then with the promo he cuts later. Oh, my goodness.
We have Marty Jannetty versus Jim the Anvil Neidhart. Rest in peace.
Rest in peace.
We have Scott Steiner versus the Vampire Warrior and somebody versus Shaw. Oh, Shaw versus Fat Fuck. Too Cold Scorpio versus Mikey Whipwreck. The Steiners versus Vampire Warrior and Dudley Squared. The Gangsters versus the Public Enemy. New Jack cuts a promo. It's the usual shit. They have Stevie and Raven going two-on-one versus Putz. Beulah gets some shots in before the Pit Bulls come in for the save. I should note that this episode on the Tape Trader has no commercials.
No commercials. No commercials.
ECW Tag Team title match. Raven and Stevie with Beulah and a towel versus the Pit Bulls. H-Dub, your thoughts on the match?
I thought it was, good shit. Stevie is the fucking man. He's killing me with the fucking shorts and the Ezekiel Elliott half shirt and shit.
But is he not one of the greatest characters that does not get their praise.
Yeah, I mean, oh man, he makes every match for me and shit. And then now he got a little girlfriend and shit. So you know, but yeah, though. Every time they come out there, I can't help but to enjoy it.
I just want to note that the Pit Bulls at this time are severely underrated. They're getting their timing down. Joey mentions the rain throughout this episode. Number two is getting noticeably better with his timing, as I noted. Number one is just pure intensity throughout the match. It's all Pit Bulls. Actually, watching this match, I actually want to see Pit Bulls versus the Steiners coming out of this match. Raven breaks up the Super Bomb. Heels take over. Good heat throughout. They have the most classic Southern tag team title match you've ever seen. Babyface Shine. Long heat with cheating distractions throughout. It's fucking amazing. Big comeback. Heels look like doofuses the entire time.
Doofuses.
Raven comes in because this is, you could tell like this is where Scotty is like booking the matches. He's like doing, he's agenting his own matches and shit. Because the Pit Bulls obviously can't work because you've seen him with the Public Enemy. You've seen him with Bad Breed. You've seen him with Jobbers and shit. And this match has more flow to it. The spots lead into each other and shit like that. They have a back and forth outside. Raven in number one, while two and Stevie are inside. Number two gets the visual pin. Beulah gets on the apron. She fumble fucks around with Towley. Number one is repeatedly running Raven's head into a fan-assisted chair. Mulano slides out, and you can imagine him just saying, "Hey, number one, stop that. Get in the ring. Get in the ring." So he's fucking distracted. Beulah pulls out the hairspray, sprays number two. You get some weak Stevie kicks, and he rolls them up. Mullenope ekes in for the win. I gave it a 4. The shit was nice. It just had flow throughout the match. There wasn't no lulls. There wasn't no rest holds and shit like that. It was just pure action, pure babyface, heels take over. Chicanery all around. The girl gets in. She does her fucking bit. It's just Memphis shit that it's formulaic, but the formula works for a reason.
Come on, somebody.
Heels with the post-match beat down. Joey is completely appalled. Beulah's face is quizzical. Tommy and Luna for the save. It goes 4-on-2, and they pop the crowd with chairs and cookie sheets. Beulah gets another pile driver. I bumped it up to 4.5. Your thoughts of the post-match shenanigans?
I love the post-match shenanigans. That's the one thing that could get me to cheer for Tommy Dreamers when he pile drives
Magilla Slutty.
Yeah. And her fucking their little skirt always come down and shit, and then you know.
And then on top of that, they modernize the fucking Memphis Southern tag team match. You know what I'm saying? So Raven took some shit he learned in Memphis. Gave it some East Coast sensibility, a little pizzazz, a little more gaga, put some bras in it, show their panties and shit like that. And the fucking crowd is just going crazy the entire time. It's perfect.
And props to Beulah for being down to get pile driven and shit.
Night after night. Joey's at the Nest doing some shilling. He mentions Rob Feinstein being let go from ECW home video. I should note, I got Super Goof deleted all the fucking members to include you, and you haven't added yourself back to the ECW memories page. Thank you very much.
Oh, I forgot.
Rob Feinstein sent me a group request.
Oh, shit.
I have yet to accept.
Dude, what you waiting on?
I steal all his shit, and he is a Kazar.
Oh.
you know they are litigious.
Good fucking point. Yeah, that's right. We don't want them problems.
Barbed wires, hoodies, and choke slams, recounted by us, Extreme Retro Review number 131. Hardcore Heaven 95, Extreme Retro Review number 135, and Heat Wave 95, Extreme Retro Review number 137. Buy any one of those three on tape, and you can get Mountaintop Madness, Extreme Retro Review number 134, for $14.95.
You're welcome, you're welcome, you're welcome, and you're welcome.
They're assholes for selling Mountaintop Madness.
They are.
We have a hot garbage promo.
Oh, man.
It's his usual awfulness. He talks shit about Taz. He says drop the bomb about 1,000 more times. 1,000 more times. 1,000 more. He talks shit about the Steiners, and they can get the bomb dropped on them, too. I think he is the fourth member of the Gap Band. Moving on. Moving on. Oh, moving on. Moving on. We have a TV title match. Shooter.
Shooter.
And Eddie. Part Infinity. I have to say, though, even though they've fought like 1,000 times, they got me in this match. I actually like this match.
I said this was the best match they've had in a while together.
Like, seriously.
Yeah.
Like, I know you like the first match, and then it goes into the snooze fest. Mm-hmm. And then they, you know, throw some six-man tags in there and try to mask that bullshit, right. But then you still fall asleep when they,
right,
when those two fucking two.
Yeah, right.
You know. Fucking goofs. Shout out to the zero subscribers of Street Smart Video for my co-conspirator pantomiming the Malenko Guerrero exchange. Yeah. I willing to bet he was Eddie because he would definitely not be the shooter.
Yeah. Ding.
It told a great story with the rib work. Eddie reverses the reverses from earlier matches and wins with another roll-up. I gave it 4 stars. Shooter protest after the match. Your thoughts?
Well, I guess I already shot my shot. But yeah, you know, great match. It wasn't just snooze fest, like you said. And, you know, it was, I'll say it again, the best match that they've had in a while among their snooze fests.
We have a phone line, Shield. It's detailing Crippler Benoit's injury from Japan. I'm calling work because he was going to WCW. And Bill Watts being brought back as a booker for Vince McMahon in 1995. Joey says, call the NAACP and the ACLU.
Oh, shit.
But only smart fans would know about that shit. H-Dub, do you know?
Only thing I can think of is because maybe Bill Watts is a racist, maybe?
Bill Watts has been touted as a racist. As before he became Booker in WCW, he was doing a shoot interview. One of the earlier shoot interviews before the RF video takeover in the mid-2000s. Mm. And he had said that he was talking about owning a restaurant. And he says, and I'm paraphrasing, that if it's my establishment, I can sell to whoever I want to. If I don't want to sell to blacks, I don't have to sell to blacks.
Oh, shit.
Now, he's absolutely right. He's absolutely right.
You know what I'm saying?
He's absolutely right. It's just the way in the 90s and the start of political correctness, it didn't rub too many people the right way. And once it got to the WCW corporate establishment, Ted Turner couldn't have that in his company. So they summarily let him go. Or he quit. Some either or. It didn't matter.
Yeah, I mean, shit, I could see how we'll rub some people the wrong way, too. Sure.
I mean, you can understand both sides.
Yeah.
But I thought we had freedom of speech.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We never had freedom of from consequence, though.
No. August 26th, Eddie and Shooter in a 2 out of 3 falls match. And Joey recaps Mikey being caned by Sandman a week ago.
About a week ago.
They play Say It Ain't So by Weezer. And it's spliced in with Sandman and Mikey's stuff. You have noted that the time was closer, and I told you that there were no commercials, and this video clocking in at about 3 minutes, plus the little bumpers, probably added to the gap.
That'll do it.
Joey then mentions Sandman Mikey feud, and he gives a Taz update. It goes to a Taz and Steiner's promo. It's forgettable. It's forgettable. Scott says something. Rick says something. And I noticed that Taz is twitching his neck the entire time. And then he rips off his fucking neck brace and he says he got Steinerized. That's what he said. That's what he said. That's what he said. That's what he said. Overall, two great matches and more storyline progression gives this show an easy thumbs up. Next week, next week, next week, cruising next week, on the way to Gangsta's next week, Paradise. Next week, oh, shoot. Be the Extreme Retro Review for August 15th, 1995. We out. Peace.
Peace.